Crayola may have dozens of colors, but they need your help to reach a million thank yous to teachers. Current and former students can upload a handwritten and colored thank you note that may be featured on the company's website. Families can also enter a contest to win prizes for themselves, their teacher, and their school. That contest launches July 1st. Enter at Crayola.com. Well, back here in St. Louis, I'm going to go ahead and get ready to make a little bit more of a mess. You know, Crayolas are not that messy, but paint is. Here we have Brian Robertson, painting instructor for the St. Louis Artists Guild. We have Carrie Kiesler, education coordinator there. What is it about paint that is so messy and so much fun?
Well, it's capable of carrying vibrant, very, very vibrant colors.
Yes.
As you can see, these raw pigments here, all you have to do is find a binder to mix them with, and then you can have a really messy substance that you can throw around and have a lot of fun creating interesting compositions.
So
with.
Throwing, is that the reason why I'm getting all dressed up here in my second
yeah.
finest?
Definitely.
Yes. So I have some pre-mixed paints here, and we're gonna fling them at the canvas over there, all right? So we got some of these pigments mixed in with these paints. And we're gonna do a little painting here.
Carrie, have you done this before? Have you done the throwing of the paints and stuff? What kind of style is that called?
Probably expressionism, but
probably
action.
We'll see. Have you seen
action painting? Is that
action painting?
Yeah.
That's
right.
A good idea. That's a good point. Okay, so can you show me how you? I'm sorry. Who is Stan the Cooking Man?
Stan the Cooking Man is actually my late grandfather, who was a woodworker and painter himself. So I got his apron and I wear it proudly whenever I do painting.
Oh, let's go
ahead. It's kind of like being in the kitchen anyway.
I see that. That's what I see, the blender. Let's go ahead and make him proud. So show me what I need to do in order to fling paint properly to make
that proud. So we have three colors here that are all different values. So different light and dark values. We have a very light paint, a middle paint, and a dark paint. And then we have it mixed up. I'm going to start with a brush. And really what we're talking about here is having gravity work, right? We're using gravity to create motion, to feel motion. I have some on the ground, like obviously our famous Jackson Pollock was really using paint on the ground, but I like to do it farther back.
Yeah.
The farther back I get,
the
more it goes, right? So I'm gonna put my light value down. I'm gonna get rid of that.
Yeah.
Let's see what other brushes I have in here to get out my middle value. And then I'm gonna just see how it captures the motion.
Looks like maroon and gold. Go Umsel, go Umsel, go Triton.
Okay. I'm gonna pour it on here.
When I pour it,
I get bigger droplets of paint. Okay.
So can I try it with the blue?
Yeah, try
it
with the blue.
All right, so what brush do you think I should grab?
This is a good brush to use. Yeah.
All right, so go ahead and mix this in. Everybody, the St. Louis Artists Guild does all kinds of awesome stuff. They have exhibits, they have classes, they have a lot of really cool stuff going on this summer. All you have to do is head to 12 North Jackson Avenue in Clayton. See what you're getting into at stlouisartistguild.org. Everybody stand back here.
All right.
On the 9 a.m. show, we'll be right back while we bring some more paint.